ברשות מוריי ורבותיי, this parasha is the last parasha of Bereshit, parashat Vayechi. We will finish all the Torah, all the stories about Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov. And Be'ez Hashem, from next week we start talking about Egypt, the exit of Egypt, Matan Torah, and again till Rosh Hashanah. But in this parasha of Vayechi, the pasuk said that Yaakov Avinu, he told Am Yisrael to his children, come all of you together, make an assembly. I want to tell you when Mashiach is going to come. That's what the Midrash said. Bigesh Yaakov ligalot et haketz. Yaakov Avinu alav shalom. He wanted to give them a little bit of consolation. Now they know that he's going to die and the exile will start. A little bit of consolation. What consolation? When Mashiach is going to come. Harit Hayamim. So what Hashem did, Hashem took the Nevuah out of him. And he did not reveal nothing. He just started to bless them. But Rabbi, one question that we have to understand. Why Be'emet Yaakov Avinu, he wanted to tell them where Mashiach is going to come. And why Hashem, he stopped him. Let him tell what the problem. It's nice to know where Mashiach is going to come. Rabbi, there is two things here we have to understand. First, Mashiach, it doesn't depend on time when it's gonna come. Mashiach depends on us. How much teshuvah we did. Mashiach has no time. He can come. All the tzaddikim can tell you tomorrow is gonna come. They can bring you from the Torah. Here is a proof Mashiach is gonna come tomorrow. Maybe it will come today, not tomorrow. Maybe it will not come tomorrow. Mashiach has billions of time when he can come. But the only time that he can force him to come, it's up to us. If we do teshuvah. If we do teshuvah, so he can come now, not tomorrow, not next year. So that's why HaKadosh Baruch Hu took the Nevuah from Yaakov Avinu. Yaakov Avinu wanted to tell the exact time. But Hashem, he wanted to tell him, it doesn't exist the exact time. There isn't an exact time. Because if they do teshuvah now, so it will come now. So, your time, even that your time is the real time, it's my time, but it's up to the divine side. So my friend, the question is, why HaKadosh Baruch Hu did not warn Yaakov Avinu not to be embarrassed? You know, Yaakov Avinu is a man of emet. He ten emet Yaakov. So, I mean, if HaKadosh Baruch Hu will not let Yaakov reveal when Mashiach is going to come, so why to embarrass him in front of his children? Why didn't warn him? Hey, Yaakov, please, don't tell your children when Mashiach is going to come, because the time that you want to tell them, it's not the time, because it's up to them. If they do teshuvah, the Mashiach will come. Like Rabotai, the prince is supposed to stay in Egypt for 100 years. At the end, how many years he stayed? 210 years. And you see, a lot of times, a culture can change. If we do teshuvah, culture can change the timing. It's up to us. So the question now, because I told you, why HaKadosh Baruch Hu didn't let, why let Yaakov talk him, embarrass him, tell him, Yaakov, don't make yourself embarrassed. And to tell him, you know, Mashiach, it's not up to me, it's up to Bnei Israel. If the Bnei Israel do teshuvah, Mashiach will come. Not at the time that you will mention to them. I would say, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he let Yaakov tell him that the time when Mashiach is going to come. And then Yaakov, he didn't say the time, but that was for something else. Demet, my friend, I always had a question. And Baruch Hashem, there is a big rabbi from Tunisia. he gave a beautiful answer. All my life I had a question. When Yaakov Abinu passed away, the brothers of Yosef, they said, well, now that Yaakov passed away, well, maybe Yosef is going to get a revenge on us for all what we did to him. So what they did, they sent some of the brothers, and they told them, go to tell Yosef that our father Yaakov, he gave an order before he passed away to forgive us for all what we did to him. And yet, when Yosef heard, he started to cry. You did nothing to me. The question is, but it's a lie. Never Yaakov told some of his sons to tell Yosef to forgive the brothers. It's like it's a lie. Because if Yaakov really wanted to say that, why didn't tell himself to Yosef, Yosef, please forgive your brothers or what they did to you? Why he has to send some of his children to tell Yosef? It's a lie. Where Rashi said, for Shalom we can lie. But still, the question is a question. So there is a big rabbi, he said, that was here, no lie. He did not lie, because before Yaakov Abinu passed away, he told his children, itatsfu vitkapsu, get together. That means, if you want Mashiach to come, if you want that you will be liberated from Egypt, you have to be united. You have to. So that means, it's a message. Yosef, don't forget, before Papa died, he called us and he told us, if we want Mashiach to come, if we want to be liberated, we have to be together. We have to be united. Yes or no? Yes. So that was an order of Papa. So you have to forgive. If that was an order of Papa. So it's like if Papa told you to forgive yourself. That it was a big chidush that I learned this week from Rabbi Shmuel Taib alav shalom. So now, according to this, understand why HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he let Yaakov talk him. Because as you say, as we saw now, that it has been used after. Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he let Yosef HaTzadik to tell them, he let Yaakov to tell them, come, I want to tell you when Mashiach is going to come. Of course, he did not tell them exactly when Mashiach is going to come, but he told them, get together. It asks for. And this is one of the secrets of Mashiach that we can come. When we are together, when we are be'ahdut. So this is the parasha that we learned from this parasha, that the end of the exile, the end of any galut that it may be, or this galut that we live together, only when there is ahdut, when we are united. We are not only united, but united, we forgive. If we did something to somebody, to forgive. Be'ezrat Hashem, this is the way how Yaakov Avinu alav shalom, he left this world with a message, ahdut.